Hey guys, so this video is going to focus on how to determine when a rational expression is undefined and then how to state the domain of it. So when we're dealing with rational expressions, we're dealing with examples that may look like this, where you could have a polynomial in the numerator and in the denominator. Now, rational expressions follow the exact same rules as regular fractions, fractions that just have regular whole numbers inside of them. Okay, so if we're thinking about a regular whole fraction, a fraction is undefined when the denominator equals zero. So if I have any fraction with a zero in the denominator, that is undefined. All right, so same concept goes for rational expressions. A rational expression is undefined when the denominator equals zero. So what we do to determine when would make this rational expression undefined is there's one step, okay? And that one step is this. Set the denominator equal to zero and solve. So whatever your denominator happens to be, in this particular example, our denominator is x squared plus 4. So I'm going to take x squared plus 4, I'm going to set it equal to 0, and I'm going to solve this thing. Now, the answer that I get for this, that's what's going to make the rational expression undefined. Now, let's go about solving this here. So if I'm trying to solve this example here, so first off, I do notice I have this exponent here, right, that tells me this is a quadratic equation. Now, if you deal with a quadratic equation, you have to try and factor it most of the time. You may try and use the square root property to try and solve this here. Most of the time, always start by trying to factor it if you're dealing with a quadratic equation. Though taking a look at this problem here, I don't really think we can factor this thing. We're talking about a binomial here. And normally when you have a binomial, you're thinking difference of squares, maybe difference of cubes or sum of cubes. Now, because I have a square here, we would go to difference of squares to try and solve this here. You do need to know a bit about factoring in order to do these problems here. If not, you should definitely go back and refresh factoring. But this does not follow difference of squares, because difference of squares says not only do you have to have two terms, they have to have different signs as well. And both of these are positive. I don't have different signs. So this is not difference of squares. Now I can go about trying to solve this thing by using the square root property. And when I'm talking about solving this thing, pretend this is a regular O equation and use your steps of solving an equation to try and solve it. For example, so here I have a positive 4, I would do the opposite and subtract 4 on both sides, leaving me with x squared is equal to a negative 4. Then a square and a square root are opposites of each other. So if I want to get rid of this square, I can take the square root of both sides. And if I do that, the square root and the square cancel, I'm left with x. But take a look at this right-hand side over here. On this right-hand side, I would be doing a square root of a negative 4. Now, I don't know about you, but you know, for me, definitely, I do know that you cannot take a square root of a negative number. It's just not possible. You can't take a square root of a negative number. That's going to give you an imaginary number, which is not the situation that we want here. So if I'm taking the square root of a negative number, this is just not possible. I can't solve this. We're going into imaginary numbers here. So that's just telling me here, or what that's telling me, if you get left with this situation here, what that means is there's nothing that I can plug in to this problem here that would make it equal zero. And think about it here. Here's our denominator. Think about any numbers that you can plug in for x, right, that would make this whole thing equal zero. Now, even if I plugged in a zero for x, that would make this zero, but I'm still adding 4 to it. Right, regardless of a positive or a negative number, or you know, whatever's going on, right? There's no possible way that this denominator would ever equal zero. So you get that by finding a situation like this where it's unsolvable, or really just stepping back and taking a look at this problem here and plugging random things into it and just seeing, hey, this is never gonna be zero. So if this is never going to be zero, then, so as far as find all values that make the rational expression undefined, there's nothing that will make the rational expression undefined. Not a zero. Zero is an actual value. Literally nothing. So maybe you can state the no set. Okay, that's like the empty set. That's nothing. Okay, so there's absolutely nothing that would make this rational expression undefined. So as far as our domain is concerned, our domain is everything. Right? Typically when we solve these problems here, our domain is everything except for those values that make it undefined. Well, we got nothing. So our domain is everything except for nothing. So literally that's everything. So our domain, there's two different ways that you can write that domain. So you can write it in roster notation, or you can write it in interval notation. So I'll show you both. If you're writing it in roster notation here, so your domain is X, which means your domain is all X such that X is all real numbers. So every real number is part of your domain, is what this notation here means. Your domain is all X such that X is a real number. Or you can also write this in interval notation. So if I'm talking about interval notation, right, think about a number line, so the span of your number line. And if we're trying to represent every single number on the number line, so then our interval notation would be negative infinity all the way to positive infinity, pretty much everything. Okay, so when finding a rational expression or finding the values that make a rational expression that's undefined, take your denominator and set it equal to zero, and then your domain is everything except that.